Hello students, welcome back to business statistics class. So in previous class we had studied Carl Pearson's or product moment coefficient of correlation. We had seen the formulas to calculate the problems. So we'll be using this formula, that is R, that is coefficient of correlation is equal to n into summation xy minus summation x into summation y whole divided by under the square root n into summation x square minus summation x the whole square into n into summation y square minus summation y the whole square. Also along with this we had seen how to interpret the coefficient of correlation values and its properties. So now we'll begin with the problems. So the first problem is calculate the product moment coefficient of correlation between the following marks in statistics and mathematics of 5 students. So number of students are 5. They have given the marks scored by these 5 students in statistics as well as mathematics. That is, the first student has scored 4 marks out of 10 in stats and 5 in maths. The second student has scored 7 and 8 and so on. So for this we have to calculate Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation between the marks in 2 subjects. So here they have asked product moment, which is nothing but Carl Pearson's. So now let us assume x to be marks in statistics and y to be marks in mathematics. So we are denoting it just for the sake of easy calculations. Instead of writing over here statistics, mathematics, statistics squares, we are denoting it with a variable. So this is the formula. Make sure in every problem you have to write the formula. So now we'll see what all terms are required. First is n, which is known, that is number of students, that is 5. Then we need summation x, summation y. So x values is given, that is marks scored in statistics is x and marks scored in mathematics is y. So these two are given in the question. So if you add all the x values, then you will get summation x. If you add all the y values, you will get summation y. So now, then we require summation x into y. So they will make another column of x into y. And then we need summation x square. So we have x, we'll make another column of x square and then take the summation. Similarly, we'll make another column for y square and then take the summation of it. So the first step is, from the question write the x and y column. So x is 4, 7, 8, 3 and 4. Y is 5, 8, 6, 3 and 5. Then we'll take x square, that is x into x. So what is 4 into 4? It is 16. 7 square is 49. 8 square is 64. 3 square is 9 and again 4 square is 16. Similarly, do it for y square. So what you have to do, you have to take the values of y and then square it. So 5 square is 25, 8 square is 64, 6 square is 36, 3 square is 9 and 5 square is 25. Then the last column will be x into y. So you have a column of x, you have a column of y. So multiply each values of x and y to get the product. So 4 5s are 20, 7 into 8 is 56, 8 6 are 48, 3 3s are 9 and 4 5s are 20. So we got all the columns. Now take the total of it. So summation x is 26, summation y is 27, that is add all these values. Summation x square is 154, summation y square is 159 and summation x y is 153. The next step is to substitute all these values in the formula. Make sure you write this formula correctly. Now n is 5 into summation x squares 153 minus, this is your summation x, this is your summation y. So I have substituted all the values. Now multiply 5 into 153, you will get 765. Multiply these two, you will get 702. Then multiply this, you will get 770. Then you have to take 26 square, that is summation x the whole square, it is 26. So it is 676. Then multiply these two, you will get 795, and then summation y whole square, that is 27 whole square, is 729. So when you subtract these two, you will get 94, and subtracting these two, you will get 66. Take the product of it, that is 94 into 66. So it is 6204. So you have to take square root of it, that is square root of 6204, it is 78.765. So the final answer will be 0.7998. So you can see here R is a positive value. We got R as positive value, and in the previous class we had discussed what about the interpretation of R values. Because we got R as a positive value, that is greater than 0, we say that there is a positive correlation between marks in statistics and marks in mathematics scored by 5 students. Also, we can say it is highly positively correlated because the value is very near to 1. The range is minus 1 to plus 1. Because it is a positive value, we say there is a positive correlation, and it is approximately equal to 0.8. So we see there is a high positive correlation between the marks. So in every problem asked, you have to write the table properly, you have to write the formula, and you have to write the interpretation whether it's asked or not. In some of the questions they might ask and give your comments or write an interpretation. If asked, and then it is definitely, if not, then make sure you write the comment. So the next problem is, the following are the heights of 8 men and their wives. Find the coefficient of correlation between the heights of husbands and heights of wives. So here n is 8 because you are taking 8 men and 8 women data. So your n is 8. They have given husband height in centimeters as well as wife height in centimeters. So for the first couple, the height is 164 for husband and 158 for his wife, and so on for 8 couples they have given the height. Now you have to check the correlation between the heights of husband and wives. So now I'll be showing two methods, that is, one is the direct method that we have seen in the previous problem, and another one is the shortcut method, that is the deviation method. So now let us assume x to be the heights of husband and y to be heights of wives. So very same like the previous problem, write the x values, write the y values, take the summation of it, then next x square, y square, and x into y. So the step remains the same. Then you have to write the formula, substitute all the values, you will get R as 0.9598. so we can say there is a high positive correlation between heights of husband and heights of their wives. So this was the direct method. It's your choice in your examination, either you can go for the direct method or the shortcut method. So this method is very similar to the step deviation or the deviation method. So now let x denote the heights of husbands and y denote the heights of wives. And now let us take u as x minus a. And here we are assuming a to be 170. You can take any values, any value in the range convenient to you. And for v it is y minus b. B we are taking 160. These are our new origins, and you can choose any values. It's of your choice. Now x is given in the question, y is given in the question. Now let us make another column u and v. What is u? It is x minus a. So you have x as 164, you have taken a as 170. So what will be u? It is 164 minus 170, which is minus 6. Make sure you write the symbol, that is, whether you get plus or minus, here you got minus. So why we are going to this method is because the calculations become very simpler. So here when you have 3 digits, you can see you get approximately 5 digits in the calculation, and sometimes it might be confusing while you are entering this in your calculators, and it is always easy to work with small numbers. So hence we go for this shortcut method. So So what is u? It is x minus a. A we have taken 170. We are taking 170 because whenever you take the values in terms of hundreds, tens or so on, it is easy to subtract. So next value will be 176 minus 170. So it is plus 6. 178 minus 170, it is 8. 184 minus 170, it is 14. So on, you calculate for all the values of x and get the new values, that is values of u. And similarly, find for v, wherein you have to subtract with the y values with 160. So 158 minus 160 is minus 2, 164 minus 160. So in place of y, substitute these values and go on subtracting with 160. You will get the v column. Once you get u and v, then the next step will be making another columns of u square, v square and u into v. So the formula for shortcut method is same. In place of x, write u, and in place of y, you write v and substitute the corresponding values. So what is n? N is 8. What is summation u into v? So it is 356. So you can see here, when you want to calculate u into v, u is minus 6 and v is minus 2. So minus into minus will become plus. Therefore, it is 6 into 2, that is 12. Similarly, 6 into 4, it is 24. 8 5s are 40. And here you can see minus 3 into minus 4 is plus 12. If 1 was plus and 1 was minus, then it would be minus 12. So be very sure with the signs. So now we got summation u v as 356. What is summation u? It is 37. So first add all the positive values, then separately add the negative values, then whichever will be the greater, subtract with that. So we get u as 37, summation u as 37 and summation v as 29. So the rest of the problem is same. You have to substitute all the summation values and simplify. So you can see we got the same answer, that is 0.9598. So in the direct method also we got exactly the same answer, wherein in shortcut method also we got the same answer. The only difference is here we are making extra two columns, that is u and v, and then we are calculating u square, v square and u into v. And if you are taking u and v, make sure in the formula you use the same variables u and v, don't write x, y. Okay, and in examination you are free to choose direct or shortcut method. So there is a high positive correlation between heights of husbands and heights of wives. Make sure you write the comment. So let us see the third problem. Calculate the coefficient of correlation between x and y by using the following data. So x values are given, y values are given. There are 7 values, so n is 7. So we'll see with shortcut method. If you want, you can solve with direct method also. So first is x table, y column, you write it, whichever is given in the question. Next, u is x minus a. Here a is assumed as 220, because here x range is from 220 till, I guess, highest value is 236. So you can take any value. You can't take, I mean, even you can take a as 10, 15, but again you will get the difference too much. So make sure you choose the value of the constant such that it is very near to the range of the given variables. Next is v is equal to y minus b. Here we are assuming b to be 12. So next, find out the values of u and v. So it is 218 minus 220, which is minus 2. 220 minus 220 is 0, and so on. Similarly, for v it is 12.3 minus 12, it is 0.3. 12.7 minus 12, it is 0.7. So 12 minus 12 is 0. 12.2 minus 12 is 0.2, and so on. Next is to get u square and v square. So minus 2 into minus 2 is 4, that is minus 2 whole square is 4. 0 square is 0, 16 square is 256, and so on. And add all these values to get summation u square. So 0.3 into 0.3 is 0.09, and so on, get v square values and then uv values. So here you can see one is plus, one is minus. So minus 2 into 0.3 is minus 0.6. So add all these uv values to get summation uv. So it is 1 plus 0.7 plus 1.1 minus 0.6. So we'll get 1 plus 0.7 is 1.7, and in this you have to subtract minus 0.6, you will get 1.1. So this is your summation uv, which is 1.1. Now we got all the values, so substitute it in the formula of coefficient of Carl Pearson's coefficient of correlation for the shortcut method, and simplify, you will get the value as minus 0.7622. So now you can see the R value is negative, therefore we can see there is a high negative correlation between the two variables x and y. And always remember, this square root value can never be 0. The numerator will be 0 because under the square root it will be always positive. So because here the numerator has negative value, you got R as negative value. So this concept is very easy if you remember the formulas and the steps to calculate. So in the next class we'll go with the next measurement of coefficient of correlation. Thank you.